Wat Coil met scatology wilde, was het onderzoeken van de verborgen kanten van de mens. Vandaar scatology dus, wat zoveel betekent als de obsessie voor de hopen stront die iedereen dagelijks produceert. Tenminste, mits geen last van verstoppingen, maar die de meesten liever zouden ontkennen. Coil dealt in angst. Door daarmee om te gaan, word je karakter gesterkt, menen de boys, die op Horse Rotorvator de vier ruiters van de apocalyps doodleuk hun eigen paarden naar de andere wereld laten helpen. Corné Evers was in Londen op de thee bij de heren Christopherson en Rushton en vroeg onder het wakend oog van wat ratten, slangen en andere gedierte naar het waarom van dit absurde beeld.
The Horse Rotorvator is a plow, earth-moving device made up of the jawbones of the four horses of the apocalypse. I didn't mean anything at all when I just had this dream. Everyone sort of says, God, I wouldn't like to be inside your head. I wouldn't like to have dreams like that. It's a normal night's work for me, really.
Mm-hmm.
I just like the phrase because it sort of conjured up a lot of images.
Mm-hmm.
You have huge horses being killed, basically. The four horses. I just like the idea of the betrayal, the fact that everyone expects the four horses of the apocalypse to come riding down with their riders. When in fact, they deceived them and they killed them, cut their throats,
ooh,
causing a second deluge of blood, a big slug, this time of blood, and then use their jaws to plow out the earth.
Most myths use imagery that is completely classical. Even Norse myths and so on are nearly all classical in their basis, and they come from a very long time ago.
Well, they are classical. I mean, the classical can be now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not that then was great and brilliant and the gods existed then and not now. I do believe they exist now in a different form, and it's up to people nowadays to realise that they can sort of live on those terms, you know, incorporate it into your everyday life.
And so
whether shopping or not.
Modern day things can have mythical or mystic overtones.
Yeah.
It can be a telephone or a television or a supermarket.
Allemaal leuk en aardig, maar niet om al te serieus te nemen. Dat vinden de heren namelijk ook zelf. Coil zou alleen maar doemmuziek maken, volgens sommigen. Louter dealen met de meer morbide kanten van onze maatschappij.
It's very difficult to analyze.
I find the strangest things in the world funny. So
simplify. Yeah, I mean, there some people say that they think that Coil music has a lot of humor in it. And other people say that they don't think it's humorous at all. And that it's totally somber and morbid.
And that's up to them, and doesn't really involve us.
For everybody to think of it in the way that they, you know, that they want. I think there is humour in it. I think it's.
Well, we deliberately include things which we ourselves find funny
or amusing, rather than not jokes.
No, they're not jokes.
So much as just.
It's a very black humour. You know, this is what goes back to the original surrealists in the fact. Well, the more I learn and read about them, they all had a sort of very, well, black sense of humour, you know, which tries to expose sort of human folly and human stupidity, really.
Op Horse Rotorvator gaat Coil in op de verschillende aspecten en verschijningsvormen van de dood. Dood en liefde. Sterker nog, de plaat eindigt met een stuk getiteld The First 5 Minutes After Death, waar je nu op het ogenblik ook naar luistert. Wat ze daarmee bedoelen?
Who's to say what happens in the first 5 minutes after death? I don't believe anyone who's dead.
It is supposed to say in the first person, that's to say. It's supposed to be the perception of someone, of the victim, rather than of other people in the area. It's not about the atmosphere in the room after someone died. It's about the experience of the person that's dead. Apart from that, it's open to the listener's interpretation.
We didn't try and sort of say, and this is what happens next, this music fits the bit which happens next, and then you go up and see a bright light. And it's just about journeys and after, full stop.
Liefde en dood hebben tegenwoordig in meer dan één opzicht raakvlakken. Het waren in eerste instantie vooral de homo's, waren ook ter wereld, die getroffen werden door het AIDS-virus. Eerder al maakte Coil een coverversie van het door Softcell bekend geworden Tainted Love en steunde met de opbrengst van die plaat de Terence Higgins Trust. Dat is een organisatie die zich bezighoudt met de opvang van AIDS-patiënten en voorlichting op dit gebied. Dat kwam ze echter op een aanklacht van de Britse conservatieven te staan, als zou de organisatie pornografie verspreiden. Hoewel in eerste instantie niet de opzet, staat uiteindelijk ook Horse Rotorvator in het teken van de AIDS.
It wasn't because of AIDS that we wanted to do those songs. It was because of AIDS that we were thinking about those things in our personal lives. Mm-hmm. And we always do songs about what we know and what we're experiencing, what we're going through. Mm-hmm. And so it's not directly one leads to the other, it's one leading to something else. Which
we were very close friends with someone called Martin, Martin Burgoyne from New York, who was Madonna's best friend for ages, for about the last 7 years. He did their first 12-inch and thing covers and their album covers.
Organized the wedding to Sean Penn.
Yeah, and we were really good friends with him and knew Madonna early on as well. And he's just died. He died in November of AIDS. And obviously, if something like that happened, you start to dwell on it, you know?
Especially if you've had sex with him. Haven't had sex with anybody else for a long time, so we're not.
We've adapted our lifestyle.
It's interesting that a lot of young people that we know, are having to make a conscious decision either to live, totally carefully and totally scrupulously, either not having sex with anybody else, or else living, doing safe sex and everything really scrupulously, or else they've gone totally the other way, and they're making obvious that they don't care about who they have sex with or. Mm. What kind of lifestyle they lead. But there's been nothing in the past 30 years that has caused people to make that kind of decision, so,
it really has got the proportions of a biblical plague or something. It really has the proportions of a biblical plague or something, It really is one of the great plagues.
De herenliefde op Tainted Love, de dood op Horse Rotorvator, onderwerpen die de luisteraar liever buiten de fraaie ingerichte living room houdt. Wil Coil shockeren? Nee, shockeren niet, maar bang maken wel.
Most horror is in fact entertainment of a very comforting sort. Mm. You know, the bogeyman, the man chasing the teenagers around with a knife, the being from outer space which pulls your head off. They've all been seen before. We want to do something that's far deeper inside you, you know.
But why?
Because I like to be frightened and I presume other people do.
Fear is not necessarily a bad thing. Fear is... It can be a creative thing because it forces one to recognize one's own limitations and to one's own mortality. Mm-hmm. In the same way that a lot of the things on the record are about one's mortality and coming to terms and accepting one's limitations. That's also true for our beliefs about things in general and things that are interesting. In general, everything that comes out of the television screen or out of the loudspeaker are designed to slow you down, to relax you, to
comfort
keep you
and
quiet.
Keep you numb and,
and what these industries must be doing is the opposite. They have to be doing things that bring you out of the complacency, out of the comfort, and into the real life and into real sense of existence. People are not consumers. Everybody is a human being who deserves the most fulfilled and rich life possible. Mm. It's not some people are creative and some people are consumers. Everybody deserves to have as rich and an interesting and fascinating life as possible, because life is quite a limited amount of time.
Coil ontdekte dat ook de door hen bewonderde Leonard Cohen ooit een libretto schreef voor de apocalyps, Who by Fire. Op Horse Rotorvator coverde Coil het. Jeff Rushton.
Now Leonard Cohen, when he came over, Tibet and that met him,